hit a woman, I don't agree with it. But okay, here's what I want to know. I mean, what makes this thing interesting? Okay, the NFL, they want to crack down on domestic violence, which, you know, in a sense, I don't agree with it, but I mean, it's an epidemic that happens around the world. But okay, but what do you do if what if she just walked up and just unloaded on him? So just because it's a female, you can't put your hands on this person. So is the guy just supposed to get beat up? I'm not saying it's right from any standpoint, but that's the point that I'm looking at, bro. What if she just walked, but thought it was somebody else and walked up to him and just threw him a left hook? And he's just supposed to just, I mean, sometimes people just react. So, you know, I'm not saying it's right. The fact that the tape actually just came out and they decide to release him, it's all kind of a conspiracy to me. It really, I don't agree with any of it, but at least try to get the whole side of the story before you just go through releasing people. I mean, it's just like, to be honest, and I'm kind of deep in, but I'm saying this to make a point. When everybody started hanging up on Adrian Peterson, this guy is abusing his child. Just because you disciplining your child and abusing is totally different. The Bible clearly states you spoil the rod, you hate your child. I don't blame him. If you have to discipline your child. Abusing and discipline is two totally different things. But to everybody,
I agree with that. I do.
It's crazy.
So, I agree with what you're saying. And, you know, players, if they get attacked, they need to be able to protect themselves.
They do.
They do.
There's a thing called self-defense.
You know, they make a lot of money, and people coming to them from every which way, like exactly. Family members they probably haven't seen in years, saying, "Hey, man, what? Right. Let me hold 100. Let me get 200 from you." You know, so I see what you're saying on there. But here's another question.
Okay.
Let's move on from that topic.
Okay.
All right. How about this? What if Alabama? What if Clemson? What if Oklahoma and Ohio State lose today?
You've named a lot of big teams.
What happens?
The sports world will be shocked.
Brian, come here. Come in here and talk about this.
Come on, Randall.
Come on. Hobble over here.
This is
your special thing. What if, okay, I just asked the question to Kinsley. What if Alabama, what if Ohio State, what if Oklahoma and Clemson lose today? What happens?
I think that Alabama and Clemson will still be in. Then you'll have Central Florida and probably somebody like West Virginia. But Alabama and Clemson still going.
What
it
about
don't matter
Michigan?
What
would Michigan?
Michigan
go in?
Michigan won't go because of the way they lost to Ohio State.
Okay.
So Alabama and Clemson, they're in. It don't matter what they do today.
Okay.
That's what I think.
All right.
But they didn't ask me. You did.
That's what I think. Okay.
Yeah. You know what? In sports world, Alabama is such. Alabama is so up there.
Yeah, they know they'll sell tickets.
Yeah.
All they got to do is put Alabama in it, and they're going to sell the tickets.
Yeah. Alabama is just the team. It's like the NCAA is so stuck on Alabama. Alabama could lose half their games, and they would still find some type of way to make them eligible for the top-ranked bowl game.
They even take away touchdowns, from other teams in the SEC.
They just pull people out. People like to pop them.
They do.
Hopefully Georgia can beat them today. I'd love to see Georgia beat Alabama today. I really would. I think it would be good for college football if Alabama loses today.
Alabama and Clemson is going and Notre Dame's going, but it would be fun to see Alabama and Clemson get beat. Just put the pressure on them, see what they're going to do.
It would be fun to see what the committee would do.
You know, it's kind of like they were saying Thursday night after the Saints got beat, that broke my heart. But you know, some other commentators were saying, it humbles them a bit. You know, sometimes people
humble
think,
pie. They need some humble pie.
Bama could use some humble.
And the Saints could afford to lose a game, and they need to lose a game before they get the playoffs.
I know.
Really wasn't a big deal to me.
Yeah, I just hate it had to come to the Cowgirls, I mean.
Let's face this. You know, the Cowboys have done a great job. Everybody was on Jason Garrett. You know, the national media was like, they should fire him. And they've won 6 games in a row. I mean, that's pretty good. I mean, hand it to the Cowboys for doing that and beating the New Orleans Saints. Because the Saints are a quality team. But let's remember, Kinsley, the last time New Orleans got beat by the Cowboys, what happened?
They won the Super Bowl.
black and gold to the Super Bowl. Ain't that right?
That's it. So, I mean, hey, if this is a repeat of that year, hey, I'm all for it. I mean, it's just two losses.
Yeah.
Hey, you have to lose a battle to win the war. Didn't y'all know that?
That is true.
Oh, yeah.
That's so true.
And y'all know what's going to happen next. Brent, are you ready for this next segment after the break? We're going to pick some games.
Uh-oh.
We're going to pick some state championship games. Uh-oh. And okay. We're going to pick some college championship games.
Okay.
And the parade's going to be starting here in about 15 minutes.
All right.
Who's ready for a parade?
I am.
You know, we're hanging out here downtown Laurel at New Look Antique and Boutique and Salon. Miss Suzanne Williams, I'm telling you, she's a great woman. They've got stuffed marshmallows in there.
Ooh.
You know, when it starts to get cold weather again, you get one of those peanut butter stuffed marshmallows, you put it in your hot chocolate, you talk about fun. It'll make you want to slap your mama.
Well, I don't know if I would finish it if I did that. I probably wouldn't start it if I did that, John.
I heard that.
Y'all know the Stringer Band's going to tear it up today.
Now, you know,
I don't know. I love the band.
I do.
But let me tell you, the Heidelberg Band always gets down.
Yeah, Heidelberg represents.
They always come gyrating through here.
The show. To be honest, the band is what really generates more of the crowd.
Yeah,
the most
It does. So, you know, I'm looking forward to the band. I don't know. Northeast Jones has a really good band. But, hey, you know, I don't know if they're going to be in it. Somebody said something because of the rain. Deteriorating a lot of people, but it looks like a lot of people still showed up and showed out today.
Yeah, rain don't stop nothing.
No, the parade's still gonna go on.
Man, this is the country now. Rain don't stop nothing.
This is Laurel, Mississippi. You know, people ain't scared of a little rain.
Yeah, you know, I don't. To be honest, I don't like getting rained on. But you know, the event is good enough. I can look over. You know, but this is exciting stuff, right? You know, you got these people out here. They're waiting for a parade, waiting, you know, for a good time. You know, this is what we get out.
It is, man. You know what I'm gonna do later on?
What you gonna do?
I'm gonna go to the Walmart and I'm gonna get me some chicken.
You going to Walmart, John?
Yeah.
Are you?
Kroger, probably.
Oh, Kroger.
I like Kroger. Get the 10 cents off your gas. You spend it. You know how it is.
There you go. Yeah.
I like Kroger.
Yeah.
Get some of them wings. You know.
Yeah.
Get some of them thighs. You know. Spread them out real nice. Get some of that teriyaki sauce and put them on the grill. Sit back, kick back, get some Sprite cranberry, and watch some football. That's what I'm looking forward to.
Living a good life, huh?
Maybe get your little lady over here making some baked beans and macaroni and cheese.
All right, man. Gonna tailgate with y'all.
Yeah. we're gonna have the Wes Jones game going on because you know she's a Wes Jones supporter.
Hey, you know, hey, well,
we play back and forth all the time. You know, that's why I love her to death. You know, so they've been picking at me this week. You know.
Yeah.
You know, but hey, you know, we still got a trophy out there.
There you go. The only one
so far.
You know what?
In the county. Now, Laurel has a bunch of them.
Yeah, but they don't. They're not in the county.
And I'm gonna tell you, Stringer has some championship trophies.
Yeah,
Stringer down the road.
Yeah, they do. You know, they've had some.
They've had some good teams back in the 90s here lately in the 2000s. Stringer's had some teams.
Yeah, they have. So yeah, but and I'm pulling for the Jones team. You know, just anytime you can say that you made it. You know, many will make it, few will win.
Yeah, that's it.
So that's just the fact that you can actually make it.
Yeah, just so you can say you made it.
I mean, too bad you won't have anything to show for but a picture.
You won't have a trophy, but hey.
You know.
It is what it is. Yeah. So we're going to have a good time up here. And I tell you, there's some good games today. We're going to talk about those and a bunch more. Granny Hole and Brent, I think we're going to beat them personally because they can't compete with us.
No.
They don't want to compete with us.
You know, we've been on the roll with these picks.
Brent don't know us football.
But he know. Hey, I don't know.
He don't know.
You might not do a clean sweep.
The only good thing he knows is Mississippi State, which I'll approve of that. I approve of that.
Okay. Well, you know, we shall see. Any given Saturday.
Hey, let's listen to another old classic Christmas song.
Let's do.
How about a little Saint Nick?
Okay.
All right. Beach Boy time.
That you've all been told, and a real famous cat all dressed up
Everybody, welcome back to Something to Talk About. We're coming to you live from New Look Antique Boutique and Salon. So, Kinsley, are you ready to pick some games?
I'm ready to pick them apart.
Brian, how about you? Are you ready to pick some games?
I'm ready to go, man.
Okay. Granny Hello, how about you?
You know I am.
All right. Remember these fine sponsors: Central Sunbelt Federal Credit Union, Kim's Nissan, Crazy 8 Vapor, Old River Road Deer Processing, Ellisville Florist and Gifts, Citrus Solution Carpet Cleaning, The Cotton Ball, Conley Christmas Tree Farm, Middleton's Tree Service, and New Look Antique Boutique and Salon. So, all right, let's start talking and picking some games, and let's start with the state championship game. Okay, are you ready, Kinsley?
I'm ready.
Are you ready for this?
I'm ready.
Okay, 11 o'clock, here in about, an hour and 9 minutes. You have Louisville taking on Poplarville. Now, this is going to be a great game. This is going to be MC Miller's last season. He's been at Louisville 45 years.
Knoxville County, some of them.
Knoxville County. He's been coaching a while. He's been in the high school association for a long time. And, you know, I tell you what, originally, I thought Poplarville might win this one, but I'm going to go with Louisville. I think Louisville wins by a touchdown. Okay. That's who I'm going with, Louisville.
Okay. To be honest, I don't know much about either team, but I've actually been hearing about Poplarville. Like I said, I don't know much about either team, but since I've heard so much chat, I think I'm going to go with Poplarville.
Okay. What about you, Brian? Who are you liking this one?
My kids
are out that way. Okay. Yeah, I like Louisville too because they're kind of like Federalfield. They got some good tradition up there, and they know how to get it done. You're right. This is MC Miller's last year. I think they'll find a way to do it. It's going to inspire them. His last year.
Okay. Well, can I get too late for to change my pick? I'm going to be the odd man.
You're going to be Poplarville.
Well, I don't want to be the odd man out.
I don't care.
I mean, I don't really know much about
either
team.
I don't care. You can't change your pick.
You go over or under, I guess.
Over or under.
Well, okay, you know what? No, I'm gonna stick
with
my team. I'm gonna stick with my team. And I have a box of tissues for all of y'all.
Well, you gonna be needing it.
Brent, I'll bring you back on.
All right, okay. How about the two-way game? Scott Central taking on Taylorsville.
Hey,
I know who you're going to pick on this one. It's going to be a sad day for them Tartars. I'm going to tell you why. Ty Keyes ain't going to be quarterbacking.
But let me stop you right
there.
Let me stop you right there and let me tell you why.
Tell me why.
Did you see what happened? Did you see how the Tartars? No, you didn't see. But let me tell
no,
you.
No, I didn't.
Let me tell you how the Tartars performed after Ty went out. Now, keep in mind, he just went out in
I'm
the first
sure the refs
quarter.
Cheated too.
No, they didn't. He got hurt in the first quarter. So there's three other quarters left. And their backup quarterback. And